Good afternoon, my dear students. Welcome to computer online class. How are you doing? I hope everyone is doing good, right? Okay. So in today's class, we're gonna start a new chapter, chapter 3, creating tables in Word 2013. So do you know what is a table? Have you seen table? Yes, do you have any idea? Yes. In school timetable, have you seen? Yes, that is a table, right? So your periods will be allotted according to the timing. So that will be in the form of a table, right? So a table refers to a set of data that may be a text, number or pictures, okay? Arranged in rows and columns. Do you know the difference between rows and columns? How the table will be? It will be like a rectangular box. These are the rows, okay? So the vertical series are called columns and the horizontal series of cells are called rows. Can you tell me in this example how many rows and columns are there? Can you count? How many rows are here? 1, 2 and 3 rows, okay? And what about the columns? 1, 2, 3, 4. So the horizontal series is called the rows and the vertical series is called the columns. Okay. See in your classroom, how we will call the first row, students. First row, how we will say? That is the horizontal series. That is the first row. We will not say that as column, right? So don't confuse it, rows and columns. This is very, very important. Okay. So this intersection of rows and columns, rectangular boxes called cells. Okay, so the intersection of this rows and columns, see this row and this column is getting intersected to form one cell. Okay, this is a cell. See the total number of cells in a table. How we can calculate it, you know? So we can multiply the total number of rows by number of columns. Okay, so number of rows multiplied by number of columns gives you the total number of cells. For example, in this picture, how many rows are there? 3 rows, right? And what about the columns? Columns, 4, right? So 3 into 4, what's the value of 3 into 4? That is 12, right? So count on the number of cells here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total 12 number of cells are there in this, okay? So the column is a vertical series of cells while row is a horizontal series of cells in a table. So this is the difference between row and column. Okay. So in a Word document, there are different ways in which we can create a table. Okay. Let's see what are the ways how we can create a table in a Word document. First is using a grid. Okay. Next, we can use an insert table option to create a table. Next, using quick tables, and we can draw custom table, and finally we can convert text to table. So there are 5 ways to create a table: using a grid, using insert table option, using quick tables, drawing custom table and converting text to table. So let's see about this in detail. Okay, first open a Word document. Okay, this is Word I have opened now. So, click blank document. Okay, now we are going to insert tables. Okay, for that what we have to do? First, using a grid. Okay, you can refer page number 33 in your book. Take your book, page number 33. First, we will see how to insert a table using a grid. Okay, so first we have to click the position where we want to insert the table. So this is the cursor, right? So here I'll click and click the insert tab. At the top you can see many tabs, right? Home tab, insert tab, design tab, right? So many tabs are there. So in that you have to click insert tab. To insert table, you have to click insert tab. See below that, can you find tables? Yes. So here is the tables group and you can find the tables option here, right? So when you click this, you can find a grid of tables, right? So this is the grid, okay? Table grid, okay? So if you want two rows and two columns, you can select as you wish. Okay, so how many columns and rows you want, you can select. You can view the number of rows and columns at the top, right? So this is 1x1, that means one row and one column. 1x2, one column is there and two rows are there, right? So first indicates the column and second value indicates the row. So here you see 4 columns and 3 rows, 4x3 table. Okay, so I have chosen this table now. Okay, now I have clicked, see, your table is here now. So how many columns are here, right? Can you check? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 rows are here. And what about the columns? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 columns. Okay. Next we will see how to insert a table using insert table option. So click the insert tab. The same options. You can click the insert tab. Click table. And below that you can see the insert table option here. Right. So can you see? So click this insert table. Okay. So when you click the insert table, you can see an insert table dialog box appears here, right? So can you see this dialog box? This is insert table. So here it's asking how many number of columns and rows you want. So if you want 5 columns, you can do, or you can increase the number of columns and rows. Okay, as you wish, you can type. Okay, then you can click OK. See, I have clicked the cursor pointer here. That's why it shows here. Okay. Let me show you again. So now here is the cursor point. Now you go to insert tab, click the table option and click insert table. You can get a dialog box, choose the number of rows and columns and click OK. See now, so table with 5 columns and 2 rows appears here, right? Okay, so 5 columns and 2 rows. So you got it now, how to insert table using insert table option. It's very simple. Okay, so next we'll see. Next, using quick tables, click the insert tab, table, and see the option here, quick tables. So when you use this quick table option, you can see some templates will appear here. See, these are templates. Okay, predefined templates. These are the layouts or designs provided in a software. So here it's in the form of table, right? So by default you can see all these features. Okay, so these are the built-in templates in a Word. So you can choose your desired one. Okay, if you choose this, you can see the table like this. Okay, you can edit the values here. Okay, so this is using quick tables. Okay, go to insert tab, table, quick table, select the desired table you want. Okay, so this is for a calendar. If you want, you can use like this. Okay, and you can replace it. If you want January, you can type January. Okay, that's it. So next is using a custom table. So what do you mean by custom? Custom means, see, you can design and draw your own table of your own choice. You can design and create, that is custom table. Okay, so Word 2013 allows you to create and design a table of your own choice. Okay, such table is called custom table. You can refer page number 34. Quick tables and custom table, you can refer page number 34. Okay, so drawing a custom table, so click the insert tab and click tables. You can see the draw table option, right? Can you see? Click this draw table. Okay, and you can draw your own table. See how many rows you want to draw, you can draw. Okay, a pen like symbol will appear there and you can draw like this. Okay, using the mouse pointer you can draw your own number of columns and rows. Okay, so are you clear with this? Okay, so you can draw the horizontal lines to make a row and vertical line to make a chord. Okay. Okay, till now we have seen, first we have drawn the table and then we have typed the text, right? So in this case, we will see how to type the text first and how to convert it into a table. So converting text to a table. So here we have the text, okay? So state and capital, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, and their capitals are given here, okay? Let's see how to convert this text to a table. You can see page number 35, the steps are given, okay? So first you have to select the text and click the insert tab and go to tables option. You can see the option convert text to table, okay? Click that option. See, a dialog box appears, convert text to table dialog box. See the number of columns, you want two columns, right? State in one column and the capitals in the next column, okay? And you click OK. See now, the state and capital is separated and it is made in two columns, right? So this is how to convert text to a table, okay? Next, we'll see entering data in a cell, okay? So now let's see how to select a row, column and cells. Okay, so first let's see how to select a row. So to select a row, move the mouse pointer to the left of the row. See, this area is called the row selection bar. Okay, so the left of the table, you can see this area is called the row selection bar. See, when you move over here, see the cursor changes to a arrow pointing rightwards, right? So now you can click in this area to select the row. See, if you want to select the second row, you can click here. So if you want to select it continuously, all the three rows, you can click and drag it on. So it will be selected. Okay. So if you want to select all the four rows, click and drag it down. Okay. So all four rows will be selected. This is how to select a row. And similarly, if you want to select a column, see, move the mouse pointer at the top. Okay, see, now this column is selected. It shows an arrow pointing downwards, right? So similarly, if you want to select the next column continuously, you can select it. Okay, this area is called the column selection bar. Okay, the area at the top of the column, this is called the column selection bar, and you can select your desired columns. Okay, so if you want to select the adjacent cells, there are two ways. Click and drag through the cells. See, you can click and drag it to select the adjacent cells, or else you can click one cell and press and hold the shift key. Okay, press the shift key and you can select it. Okay, these are the two ways. One thing, just click and select it, or hold the shift key and then click the other cells. Okay, it will be continuously selecting the cells. Okay, for selecting non-adjacent cells, that means first you want to select this one and next you want to select this. For this, what you have to do, you have to press the control key and you can double click the cell. Okay, see, here and there you can select it in random. Okay, this is using the control key. Okay, Okay, my dear students, I hope everyone is clear with today's topic, right? If you have any doubts in this, you can contact me and you can clarify your doubts. Okay, thank you, dear children. Have a great day.